this blind, deaf, mute woman. Can nothing be done to disinter this human soul? The whole neighborhood would rush to save this woman if she were buried alive by the caving in of a pit, and labor with zeal until she were dug out. Now, if there were a person with as much patience as zeal, such a person might awaken her.
Annie? Annie, you there?
Hush.
Annie, what's that noise? Just a cot, Jimmy. Why are they pushing it?
To the dead house.
Annie, does it hurt to be dead?
There is schools. There is schools outside where they teach blind ones worse than you to read and write. There is schools outside where they...
You ain't going to school, are you, Annie?
When I grow up.
You ain't either, Annie. You're going to stay here and take care of me.
I'm going to school when I grow up.
You said we'll be together forever and ever.
I'm going to school when I grow up.
Little girl, I must tell you, your brother will be going on a journey soon.
I will not have it. Now, you did not see when that girl after supper tonight went to look for Helen in her room. The child practically climbed out of her window to escape from her. What kind of teacher is she? From the moment she got off the train, she's been nothing but a burden. Incompetent, impertinent, ineffectual, and
immodest. She folded her napkin, Captain.
What?
Not ineffectual. Helen did fold her napkin.
What in heaven's name is so extraordinary about folding a napkin?
More than you did, Captain.
Katie, I did not bring you all the way out here to the garden house to be frivolous. The fact is, today she scuttled any chance she ever had of getting along with the child.
What do you wish me to do?
I want you to give her notice.
I can't.
And if you won't, I must. I simply will not have her here in the... Miss Sullivan.
Viney said I'd find you both out here in the garden house. I thought we should have a talk.
Yes, come in.
Katie?
Captain?
Yes, sir. I first wanted to make my position clear to Mrs. Keller in private. I have decided I'm not satisfied. In fact, I'm deeply dissatisfied in the manner in which you...
Is this little house ever in use?
In the hunting season. If you will give me your attention, Miss Sullivan. Now, I have tried to make allowances for you, because you come from a part of the country where people are... Women, I should say. Come from... For who? For whom? Allowances must be made. I've decided, nevertheless, that is decided I... Miss Sullivan, I find it very difficult to talk through those glasses.
Oh, of course.
Why do you wear them? The sun's been down for an hour.
Any kind of light hurts my eyes.
Put them on, Miss Sullivan. I have decided to give you another chance.
To do what?
To remain in our employ. But if you are to stay, there must be a radical change in manner.
Whose?
Yours, young lady! Isn't it obvious? And the second is that you persuade me there's the slightest chance of you ever teaching a child who runs from you now like the plague.
What? Miss Annie?
It's hopeless here. I can't teach a child who runs away.
Then do I understand you propose to?
Well, if we all agree it's hopeless, the next
Miss Annie, I am not agreeing. I think perhaps you underestimate Helen.
I think everybody else here does.
She did fold her napkin. She learns. She learns. Do you know she began talking when she was only 6 months old? She could say water. Not really, but wawa. Wawa, but she meant water, and she knew what it meant. And at only 6 months old, I never saw a child so bright and outgoing. It's still in her. Somewhere. Isn't it?
Mrs. Keller, I don't think Helen's worst handicap is deafness or blindness. I think it's your love. And pity.
Now, what does that mean?
All of you here. You're so sorry for her. You've kept her like a pet. Why, even a dog, you housebreak. No wonder she won't let me come near her. It's useless for me to try to teach her language or anything else here. I might as
Miss
well.
Miss Annie, before you came, we spoke of putting her in an asylum.
What kind of asylum?
For mental defectives.
I visited there. I can't tell you what I saw. People like animals. What else are we going to do if you give up?
Give up?
You said it was hopeless.
Give up? Why, I only today saw what has to be done to begin. I want a complete charge of her.
Now, you already have that, and it's resulted in nothing but...
No, I mean day and night. She has to be dependent on me.
For what?
Everything. The food she eats, the clothes she wears, the air she breathes. Whatever her body needs is a primer to teach her out of. It's the only way. The one who lets her have it should be her teacher. Not anyone who loves her. You have so many feelings. They fall over each other like feet. You won't use your chances, and you won't let me...
But if she runs from you to
yes,
us...
Yes, that's the point. I'll have to live with her somewhere else.
What?
Till she learns to depend on and listen to me.
For how long?
As long as it takes. I've packed half my things already.
Miss Sullivan!
Captain Keller, it beats both of your conditions. It's the one way I can get back in touch with Helen. And I don't see how I can be rude to you again if you're not around to interfere with me.
And what is your intention if I say no? Pack the other half for home and abandon your charge?
The asylum! I grew up in such an asylum. The State Almshouse. Maybe you'd like to know what Helen will find there, not on visiting days. One ward was full of the old women, crippled, blind, most of them dying. But even if what they had was catching, there was nowhere else to move them. And that's where they put us. There were younger ones across the hall, prostitutes mostly, with TB and epileptic fits. And a couple of the kind who keep after other girls, especially young ones. And some insane, some just had the DTs. The youngest were in another ward to have babies they didn't want. They started at 13, 14. They'd leave afterwards, but the babies stayed. A lot of them had sores all over from diseases you're not supposed to talk about. But not many of them lived. The first year we had 80, 70 died. The room Jimmy and I played in was the dead house, where they kept the bodies until they could dig.
Oh, my dear.
The graves. No. It made me strong. But I don't think you need send Helen there. She's strong enough. No, I have no conditions, Captain Keller.
Miss Annie?
Yes.
Where would you take Helen?
Oh, Italy?
What?
Can't have everything. How would this little garden house do? Furnish it. Bring Helen here after a long ride so she won't recognize it. You can see her every day if she doesn't know. Well?
Is that all?
That's all.
With your permission, Captain.
Miss Sullivan, do you like the child?
Do you?
You could have a servant here.
Oh, I'll have enough work without looking after a servant, but that boy Percy could sleep here. He could run errands.
We could let Percy sleep here, I think.
And
Captain.
Some old furniture, all our own.
Captain, do you think that walnut dresser...
I have not yet consented to Percy, or to the proposal, or to you staying on here, or to Miss Sullivan staying here when I... Very well, I consent to everything. 2 weeks. I'll give you 2 weeks in this place, and it will be a miracle if you get the child to tolerate you.
2 weeks, Miss Annie? Can you accomplish anything in 2 weeks?
Anything enough. 2 weeks and the child comes back to us. Well, what is it, Miss Sullivan? Think of your mind, yes or no?
2 weeks. For only one miracle. I'll get her to tolerate me. First of many. 26. I've always wanted to live in a doll's house.
You don't let things go easily, do you? How will you win her hand now in this place?
Do I know? I lost my temper, and here we are.
No touching, no teaching. Of course, you are bigger.
I'm not counting on force. I'm counting on her. That little imp is dying to know.
Know what?
Anything. Any and every part of God's creation. I'll have to use that appetite, too.
Maybe she'll teach you.
Of course.
That she isn't. That there's such a thing as dullness of heart, acceptance, and letting go. Sooner or later, we all give up, don't we?
Maybe you all do. It's my idea of the original sin.
What is?
Giving up.
You won't open her? Why can't you let her be? Have some pity on her for being what she is.
If I ever once thought like that, I'd be dead.
You will be. Why trouble? Or will you teach me? She knows she could be in another town.
That's her sign for me.
I know.
Miss Annie, please be good to her. These 2 weeks trying to be very.
Did I get into now?
I can't understand it.
I had every intention of dismissing that girl, not setting up like an empress.
Yes, what's her secret, sir?
Secret.
That enables her to get everything she wants out of you when I can't.
She does not get everything she wants.
Don't,
Captain.
Don't.
He's afraid. Well, what does he want from me?
My God, don't you know?
Everything that you forgot when you forgot my mother.
What? One thing this girl's secret is not. She doesn't fire one shot and disappear.
Letting this girl have what she needs.
Why can't my son be? He can't bear me. You'd think I'd treat him as hard as this girl does Helen.
Perhaps you do.
He has to learn some respect.
Do you like the child? How empty the house is tonight.
I won't have it. On either of us. I will touch you. How do I? Percy!
me go. Let me go. Oh, she's trying to talk. She's gonna hit me.
She can talk. She only knew. I'll show you how. She makes letters. This one is C. C. She's mad at me now, though she wants to play. She knows lots of letters. Here's another. A. C. A. C. A. C. A. K. She spells cake. She gets cake. She doesn't know yet it means this. Isn't it funny? She knows how to spell it and doesn't know she knows. All right, she won't play it with me, I'll play it with you. Would you like to learn one she doesn't know?
No.
M. I. L. K. M is this. I, that's an easy one, just the little thing. L, no, why should I talk to you? I'm teaching Percy a new word. L, K is this. Oh, you're jealous, are you? All right. Good. So I'm finally back to where I can touch you, hmm? Touch and go. No love lost. But here we go. Go to bed now. You've earned your sleep. Now all I have to teach you is one word. Everything. Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Mama's gonna buy you a mockingbird. If that mockingbird don't sing, Mama's gonna buy you a diamond ring. If that diamond ring turns bright, Mama's gonna buy you a looking glass. And if that looking glass gets broke, Mama's gonna buy you a billy goat. If that billy goat won't fall, Mama's gonna buy you a cart and boat. If that cart and boat turns over, Mama's gonna buy you a dog named Rover.
Water, Helen. This is water. W A T E R. It has a name.
M-I-C-A-R. It has a name, and the name stands for the thing. Oh, it's so simple. Simple as birth to explain. Helen, the chick has to come out of its shell sometime. You come out too. There's only one way out for you, and it's language. To learn that your fingers can talk and say anything. Anything you can name. This is mug. M-U-G. Mug. It has a name. It has a name.
You didn't eat any breakfast, my dear.
I hadn't the appetite.
You need to eat, Katie.
It'll be a long day of waiting.
But it has been a short 2 weeks. I never thought life could be so noiseless. Went much too quickly for me.
C-A. R D card C A R D.
The house has been practically normal.
Jimmy,
is it wrong to enjoy a quiet breakfast after all these years? You two seem to enjoy each other.
The house would be even more noiseless without your tongue running every minute.
Now, haven't you enough feeling to understand what Katie's been undergoing?
Captain. True. These 2 weeks have been normal. Quiet, all you say, but not short. Just empty.
W-A-T-E-R. What it means, this. W-A-T-E-R. This. W-A-T-E-R.
I only meant that Miss Sullivan is a boon, of contention though it seems.
If and when you are a parent, Jimmy, you'll understand what separation means. A mother loses a protector.
Hmm?
You'll learn. We don't just keep our kids safe. They keep us safe.
I feel every day more and more in adequate.
Kate, I'm sorry. When I open my mouth like a fairy tale, frogs come
out. No, it has been better for everyone.
What does he want from me?
That's not the question. Stand up to the world, Jimmy. That comes first.
But the world is him.
Yes, and no one can do it for you.
Kate, at least you and I. Could you be my friend?
I am.
My mind is undisciplined, full of skips and jumps and disinter, disinterested, disjoin, disinterested. Where's discipline? What a dictionary. You have to know how to spell it before you can look up how to spell it. Disciple. Discipline. Discipline. Undisciplined.
You're not to overwork your eyes, Miss Annie.
Well, whatever I spell to Helen, I better spell right.
How serene she is.
such a little lady. She'd sooner starve than eat with her fingers.
You've taught her so much these 2 weeks. I never...
Not enough. Obedience isn't enough. Well, she learned 2 nouns this morning, key and water. That brings her up to 18 nouns and 3 verbs.
But not...
No. Not that they mean things. It's still a finger game to her. No meaning. Mrs. Keller, shall we play our finger game?
How will she learn it?
It will come.
How?
How does a bird learn to fly? We're born to use words like wings. It has to come.
But how?
All right. I don't know how. I've done everything I could think of. Whatever she's learned here. Keeping herself clean, knitting, stringing beads. All of it I spell. Everything we do, we never stop spelling. I go to bed with writer's cramp from talking so much.
Oh, I worry about you, Miss Annie. You must rest.
Now, she spells back in her sleep. Her fingers make letters when she doesn't know. In her bones, those 5 fingers know. That hand aches. Aches to speak out. Something in her mind is asleep. How do I nudge that awake? That's the one question.
With no answer.
Except keep at it. Like this.
More time?
Spell it.
Because I can't.
Miss Sullivan, I was on my way to the office.
Outside,
my dear girl, you're 2 weeks up today. Surely you don't object to the agreement?
Not until 6 o'clock.
Come now, what difference can one fraction of a day make?
An agreement is an agreement. Now, you've been very good. I'm sure you can keep it up for a few more hours.
Miss Sullivan, you are a tyrant.
Likewise, I'm sure.
You don't think you know how eager we are to have her back in our arms.
I do know, and it's my main worry.
It's like expecting a new child in the house. Well, she is. So composed, so manageable. Contented, cleaner, more...
Cleaner.
Well, we say cleanliness is next to godliness,
Cleanliness is next to nothing. She has to learn that everything has its name. That words can be her eyes. To everything in the world outside her and inside, too. Don't you see that everything she's learned here is only clearing the way for that? I can't risk her unlearning it. Give me more time alone with her, another week.
But doesn't she need affection too, Miss Annie?
She never shows me she needs it. She won't have any caressing.
Look, what is she spelling?
Water?
Teaching a doll to spell. I think you ask too much of her and yourself. God may not have meant for her to have the eyes you speak of.
I mean her to. Half a week.
An agreement is an agreement.
Mrs. Keller,
I want her back.
I'll send Viney to help you pack up.
Not until 6 o'clock. I have her until 6 o'clock.
6 o'clock. Come, Katie.
D-O-L-L. Doll. D-O-L-L. Here. Water. Water. I don't know. I don't know how to tell you. Not a soul in the world knows how to tell you. Helen. Helen. Yes. What's it to me? They're satisfied. Give them back their child, housebroken, and everyone satisfied. But me and you. Reach. Reach. I wanted to teach you. Everything, everything, everything the earth is full of, Helen, and everything on it that's ours for a wink and it's gone. And what we are on it, the light we bring to it and leave behind in words. Why, you can see 5,000 years back in the light of words. Everything, everything we feel, think, know, and share in words. So not a soul is in darkness. Even in the grave. And I know, one word, I can put the world in your hand. And whatever it is to me, I won't take less. But how? How? How do I tell you? How do I tell you that this means a word, and that word means this thing, wool. Or this, S-T-O-O-L, means this thing, stool. Napkin. Dress. F. A. C. E. Face. M-O-T-H-E-R. Mother. M-O-T-H.
Let her come.
Mother.
You said we'd be together forever. You promised forever and... Annie?
But that bottle is dead and gone. Why not let it stay buried?
I think God must owe me a resurrection.
What?
And I owe God one.
Forever and ever. Forever and ever and... Forever and ever and ever.
Miss, Anne. I've been waiting to give you this.
What?
Your first month's salary. With many more to come, I trust. It doesn't express how we feel. It doesn't repay our debt for what you've done.
What have I done?
Taken a wild thing and given us back a child.
Taught her one thing. No. Don't do this. Don't do that.
It's more than all of us could in all the years we have.
Obedience without understanding is a blindness, too. Is that all I've wished on her?
No, no.
Maybe. I don't know what else to do. Simply go on. Keep doing what I've done. And have faith that inside is waiting like water underground.
It's enough for us.
You can help, Captain Keller.
How?
Even learning no has been at a cost of much trouble and pain. Don't undo it. The world isn't an easy place for anyone. I don't want her just to obey, but to let her have her way in everything is a lie to her, and I don't even love her. She's not my child. You've got to stand between that lie and her.
Agreed. Won't you come now to supper?
I used to wonder how I could earn a living.
Oh, you do.
I really do. Now the question is, can I survive it?
Evening, General.
Will you say grace, Jimmy?
And Jacob was left alone and wrestled with an angel until the breaking of the day. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And the angel said, "Let me go, let me go, for the day breaketh." And Jacob said, "I will not let thee go, except thou bless me." Amen. Oh, you angel.
That's a very strange grace, James.
Will you stop the muffins, Ev?
It's from the good book, isn't it?
Miss Annie?
Thank you.
There's an awful lot of things from the good book that I wish we had to hear just before eating.
Pickles on that?
Oh, I should say so. You know, my parents have good pickles.
Oh, this is the end of them, I'm afraid. I didn't put up nearly enough last summer.
Reverend, look looked in at the office to complain his hands had stopped laying.
I've always suspected those hands.
Of what?
I think they're Yankee hands. Has he...
James? No, you're pulling my lower extremity. Next thing you know, we'll...
We had a little talk, and Miss Annie thinks that if we give in to these kind
of... What's the child done?
She's learned not to throw things on the floor and kick. It took us the best part of 2 weeks.
But only a napkin is not ethical or breakable.
And everything she's learned is. Mrs. Keller, I don't think we should play tug of war for her. Either you give her to me, or you keep her from kicking.
Well, what do you wish to do?
Let me take her from the table.
Oh, let us see. My goodness. She's only a child. She doesn't want to wear a napkin. She doesn't have to her first evening.
And ask outsiders not to interfere.
I'm the child's aunt.
Lil wants her so much, Miss Annie. I made all of Helen's favorite food tonight.
It's a homecoming party, Miss Annie.
She's testing you. You realize.
She's testing you.
Jimmy.
And wants to see what will happen. At your hands. I said it was my main worry. Is this not what you promised me half an hour ago?
She's not kicking now.
And not learning not to. Mrs. Keller. Teaching her is bound to be painful to everyone. I know it hurts to watch, but she'll live up to just what you demand of her and no more.
She's testing you.
Jimmy, be quiet.
I have an opinion.
No one's interested in hearing your opinion.
I am interested. Of course, she's testing me. Let me keep her to what she's learned, and she'll go on learning from me. Take her out of my hands, and it all comes apart. Be bountiful. It's at her expense. Please pass me more of her favorite foods.
Take her, Miss Annie.
Thank you.
I'm afraid you're the difficulty, Miss Annie. Now, I'll keep her to what she's learned. You're quite right there. But I don't think we need to send her from the table. After all, she's the guest of honor. Bring her plate back.
She was a seeing child. None of you would tolerate.
Well, she's not. And I think some compromise can be made. Bring a plate, please. There. It's not unnatural. Most of us take an aversion to our teachers, and oftentimes another hand can help smooth things out. Now, shall we start all over?
Just started off.
Don't get up!
Where are you going?
Don't smooth anything else out for me. Don't interfere in any way. I treat her like a seeing child because I ask her to see. I expect her to see. Don't undo what I do.
Where are you taking her?
To make her fill this pitcher again.
You let Pa speak to you like that, Arthur. A creature who works for you.
No, I don't.
Let her go.
What?
I said let her go. She's right. She's right. Kate's right. I'm right. And you are wrong. If you drive her away from this place, it will be over my dead chair. Has it ever occurred to you that even on one occasion you may be consummately wrong?
Please sit down, everyone. Please sit down, Jimmy.
All right, pump. No, she's not here. Pump. Water. 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 It hasn't
teacher,